So to answer this, let's think about the pseudocode we had before. We have this while loop where we need to know as the stopping condition if date one is before date two. And then we have the body that keeps incrementing the date. Well, we've got our procedure now to do this part. Right? We implemented the next day. That we were ready to turn into code. If we're going to write a helper procedure, we should write something that makes it easier to do this date comparison. And that's going to be a lot better to do as a helper procedure than to try to do that inside the days between dates code. Knowing whether a date's before another date is something that is possibly useful in other contexts. We'll actually see another use for it in writing this. The other advantage of writing that as a separate helper procedure is we can test that separately. So instead of starting by writing days between dates right away, it would make a lot more sense to start by writing a helper procedure that determines the stopping condition. So let's do that. We're going to write a procedure, date is before, that takes as inputs two dates, still encoded as three values, and it's going to return true or false, telling us whether year one, month one, and day one is before year two, month two, and day two. If you weren't able to write the code for days between dates on your own, now that you've heard this hint, please try again, see if you can do it. Writing date is before first and testing that that's correct before you go on to writing the days between dates procedure. I'll show you my code next.